Only a man is now alive who saw the dreadful deed. But back in 1835, in history you may read, oh, high up with Michigan, they fought as hard as two states can to prove which was the better man, and prove just how their border ran, and where the rights of each began, and which would have Toledo.
The CBS Radio Workshop, dedicated to man's imagination, the theater of the mind. Tonight, The Toledo War, a new opera performed for the first time, with words by Edward Eger and music composed and conducted by David Brookman. It was in 1835, when Michigan was still a territory, that the young governor, Stevens Thompson Mason, claimed that a strip of land, including the town of Toledo, rightfully belonged to Michigan. But some people in Ohio thought differently, and so it was war, the first war between the states. Exactly what happened isn't too clear, but it might have been something like this.
Just tell a storm and strife occurred, we're here to show you you, and you will have to take our word that all we say is true.
Hard by Lake Erie's fearful foam, the shot began to fly, oh. We take you to the happy home of Federal Judge Phineas Fustian
and his wife Permelia Fustian
and his daughter Annabelle Fustian
of Toledo, Ohio.
Stirring news of war assails our ear, according to the latest thing we hear. The men of Michigan have made complaints, our town is in their state, we say it ain't. So now with savage skill and aim adroit, they're planning to invade us from Detroit. To Stinkney, are you ready to go forth and guard us from these vandals of the north and battle to the joy of all bystanders to keep our city safe, our Michiganders? Then, homie, lay my daughter as your bride. Have you your forces ready?
Well, I've tried. My brothers were the only ones who came. But we will guard you safely all the same. They're waiting just outside the door. My brother one, my brother three, my brother four.
Good evening, one.
I'm three.
Oh, I see.
My father was a military man, and he named us by a military plan. And he formed us in a group, and he trained us in a troop to be as military as we can.
We're the one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Sing me, brothers.
We've been looking all our lives for an enemy.
Any enemy.
Any enemy.
Anyone with whom we don't agree.
Don't agree. Don't agree.
And should any sneak and spy come here to peek and pry, we'll hit him in the eye and sit around and watch him die, just to show Ohio that Ohio can rely.
One, two, three, four. Say we are Ohio.
Isabel.
London brain has two. By some he might be called that too. His hair is growing bald, that too. But when the battle's din is through, then wealth and fame he'll win. Will too.
He sings to me with quaking heart. I wonder why. justify.
Good evening.
A stranger.
Do we know you, sir?
Alas, no.
But...
Hush, not a word. Forgive me. I lost my way, and having my mandolin with me, improvised a serenade to warm my fingers. They're warmer now.
Oh, sir.
And now that I meet with such charm and beauty, too, I can only repeat every word I sang was true.
Well, really.
Hush. Be careful.
Sir, I'm a married lady. I am an engaged young lady.
Brothers, if you are recognized, you will be killed
and will be compromised.
Where can I hide?
Under there.
Where?
There, get inside. Quick, move the chair. I see his hair.
Seen a man from Michigan, but then he ran. You've seen a man
as quiet as a mouse. We saw him creeping. We'd better search the house.
No, my uncle's sleeping.
Oh, did you know he was from Michigan? Did he wear a uniform?
No, that's so. He didn't wear a uniform.
It would be just like them dirty Michiganders not to wear a uniform.
It would, that's good. Them dirty brutes wear business suits.
Oh, dear too, how can you think that I would hide a spy?
No.
No.
Go.
Oh.
It is safe now. You may emerge.
How can I thank you?
It was nothing.
And now you must be weary from your exertion. Girls, some refreshment for the gentlemen.
The cold roast lamb.
A slice of ham.
The cider cool. And gooseberry full.
To your door. How can you feed him your gooseberry fool and cream? Suppose he is a spy, come here to lurk and scheme.
Hush, what are you saying?
Well, suppose he is a spy, what then? War is the concern of men.
And when the stranger has such manly grace, such a lofty mind, such a noble face. Supposing it were so, I'd rather never know and think of him as though he were a lovely dream.
Well, I can only say I consider your behavior hypocritical in the extreme.
Amelia! What is that voice of thunder?
My husband.
My father.
Should I surrender?
No, get back under.
What does this mean? The hour is late. You know the house is aglow.
We weren't sleepy.
We weren't sleepy.
Gooseberry fool on the parlor table. Suppose the neighbors should know.
We were hungry.
We were hungry.
You must curb this tendency to madcap frolic. Often I told you so.
Yes, I know.
Yes, we know.
Law and order. Status quo.
I know.
Put out the light.
I'll bring the light.
Come out now. It's all right.
I'd like to stay and talk if things could be as they might. But since they aren't quite, I'd better say good night.
Good night.
Bon appetite.
I'll bring the light.
Really, such hypocrisy. They pretend to be for Ohio. Then all for the sake of a handsome face, they entertain a spy. Oh!
What about you, my dear?
I'm not your dear. I look on you with loathing, you sneaking Wolverine in buck-eye clothing. I knew you were a spy, but I thought you'd spy with candor, not stoop to lie and flirt and philander.
But a spy must lie.
I don't see why.
Nathan Hale and I could tell you that a spy must learn to lie and lie if he'd be a good spy.
Well, of course, that's different. If it's true what you say, I'm learning something new every day. My uncle convinced me to fight for my state, but now my state is Michigan, the state of my mate. So now I'm a spy, and I think if I try, I can learn to lie, and be a good spy. But how did you come here, and what is the occasion?
I came from Detroit with a party of invasion. We plan to make for the courthouse with a speedo, to draw up a deed or to claim Toledo. But the night it was dark and the way it was tricky. I got lost in the swamp and the swamp it was sticky. And I couldn't find the courthouse, for my knowledge it was scanty. So I finally came to this house of your auntie.
But this is the courthouse. My uncle holds court session right here in the parlor every Friday.
Then 9 points of the law I've won, for I am in possession without having hardly tried it.
There's paper in the desk and quills and ink.
Toledo will be Michigan as quick as a wink.
Now to draw up the deeds and writs.
Order in the court. The court sits.
It's done.
It's done.
It's done.
It's done.
We've won.
We've won.
We've won.
We've won.
Strange as it may seem, we've worked on a scheme. So now let's have some gooseberry fool and cream. Delicious.
Sweetheart.
Darling, you eat parm.
Thank you.
My dear.
I see him. He's in there. Up with your hands and
of leather and feathers and tar. Ride him on a rail and the jailhouse land him.
Away, unhand me!
Away, unhand him!
On gallows hill we'll hang you high. Why?
Don't ask why, don't ask why. For you know the reason. You're a spy, and you're guilty of treason.
I'm a spy.
So am I.
But my ethics don't forbid it.
For his ideals are high.
It is for my state I did it.
Me, oh my,
why
this glamour so alarming?
He's a spy, he's a spy.
But he is so young and charming.
What's amiss, what's awry, what's the noise and what's the riot?
He's a spy, he's a spy.
Take him out and hang him high.
Will you shoot him or shall I?
He's a spy, he's a spy, he's a
quiet. You have no right to seize me, for from this date, Toledo is no longer even in your state. Read this paper.
Heaven forbid. Niece, you signed this?
Yes, I did.
You are guilty of fraud, impersonating an officer, and contempt.
Not at all, I am exempt. You told me states' rights are the highest right.
Sustained.
And that's when I decided to join the fight.
Sustained.
I am a citizen of the state of Michigan. I am secretly married to this gentleman.
Isabel, I am paid.
But you don't know him. Oh, can this be? I do too. We met last April at a Sunday school picnic in Maumee. I adore him, I did it
for him. You flout old accord to wed this cockalorum. But though we deplore him, we still can't ignore him. For two may be company, but it isn't a quorum.
It isn't a quorum, it isn't a quorum.
It isn't a quorum. Still in Ohio, it's all hunky-dorum.
I said open forum, we did have a quorum. Toledo's in Michigan.
Toledo's in Ohio, Toledo's in Ohio.
We'll make you wish and wish again you'd never been a spy.
We'll hang you Ohio and lead you to trial.
Stop that or you die. Come quick, let us fly.
Oh, dear, oh, goodbye, oh, we'll go death our army and battle with Ohio. Goodbye, oh, goodbye.
We'd like to see you try, oh, just try, oh, just try.
Goodbye, oh, goodbye, oh, goodbye, oh, goodbye.
Who knocks? Who knocks? At such an hour unorthodox, when ten is striking on the clocks. Who knocks? Who knocks? Unlock the locks. Let's see who knocks.
Special message from President Andrew Jackson.
Andrew Jackson?
In the interest of national unity, the president decrees that this community, up to now in a state of ambiguity, shall be in Ohio for perpetuity.
Oh, joy!
In Ohio.
So now you know.
sadly I bow to the president's order. I linger no longer south of the border. Come home with me, Isabel, and find safe harbor, and live happy ever after in Ann Arbor.
No, no, I object.
Objection overruled.
Don't we get to shoot nobody?
No,
the battle had a happy end the same night it began, and each man was each other's friend by President Jackson's plan. So let's be glad it turned out right, as battle seldom can. And let's be happy that tonight, though years and years have passed in flight, Toledo still is shining bright. Wheels are turning left and right, and champions Spark, Plug, and Willis Knight, and Mather Spring, and Autolite are in Ohio. But they might have been in Michigan.
Tonight, the CBS Radio Workshop has presented The Toledo War, a parlor piece for music, with words by Edward Eager and music composed and conducted by David Brookman. The cast included Arthur Newman as Judge Phineas Fustian, Gene Hanslick as his wife, Lois Winter as Annabelle, Shirley Emmons as Isabel, Peyton Higginson as the hero, and Mike Pollock as Stinkney II. Others included John Wilson, Jack Brown, and Bill Marine. The CBS Radio Workshop is produced in New York by Paul Roberts. This is Bob Hite inviting you to join us again next week when we present When He Shall Appear. This is the CBS Radio Network.